Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Hirody Okato, and I'm doing my presentation on music. So first of all, what is music? Obviously, Yeezy doesn't know. Anybody else know here what music is, the definition of music? Well, according to Webster, music is the sounds that are sung by voices or played on musical instruments. But in my opinion, I have like a different phrase for it. To me, it's more like music is poetry with instrumentals in the background. Like my friend over there, Caesar, said. And I also have another definition aside from songs, that music is life. No matter where we are, no matter where we go, we always hear one sound, and that sound can be repeated or altered into what can be music. As one presenter, Sean, he had us stomp, clap for his song. That was music. So that was just an example. The origins of music. Right now, the history is unknown or debatable. Scientists are saying they don't know whether to count human interactions or animal noises like birds whistling as music. And aside from that, what prehistoric people have done in the past, you know, maybe Fred Flintstone was rocking out to that song he was playing in the movie. Oh, I forgot the name of it. But like I said, music can go all the way back to the prehistoric time era, before 500 AD, and it goes into ancient times, and early music or medieval music and Renaissance music came to life, which was from 500 to 1600. And then you have common practice where classical music came into the picture, as well as Romantic and Baroque, which was from 1600 to 1910. And then you have what today is modern and contemporary, which is the genres that I'm going to show slowly after this. Slowly has evolved into music we listen to today. Everything we have right now in the past was more of a simpler version. So I'm going to start with pop. We got the king of pop himself, Michael Jackson. And right there on the side I have today's pop charts, Animals being number one, which I'm sure we all heard. And the term pop came from obviously popular music. And it is what it is. In general, pop isn't a genre. It's more of a collection of what is popular in today's society. Constantly being played on the radio, no matter where you are. If you turn the radio on, you hear at least one of these songs today. And originally derived from rock and roll. So nowadays, it's more of a opposition towards rock and roll. And you have today's famous artists, Katy Perry, Lady Gaga, Rihanna, Michael Jackson, and Ariana Grande. Then you got country. Those are the charts today. And originated in the southern United States around the 1920s. Majority of the genres were originated in America, except for one. And it was no other than country. It was hillbilly music and folk music. It also often consisted of ballads, as you can hear in the background. And fun fact, in 2009, country music was the most listened to music during rush hour, which is surprising. And myself, I ask people, what music do you listen to? And I hear other people ask. And majority of the time, they will say, I listen to everything except country. So, but obviously, some notable instruments are guitars and banjos. And some famous artists will be Taylor Swift, Carrie Underwood, Keith Urban, Blake Shelton, and Tim McGraw. Then you got rock. I'm sure we're all familiar with it. Today's charts are a bit iffy for rock in general. But rock has been heavily influenced by R&B and country, surprisingly to me. I found that interesting. Usually stresses romantic love, but also emphasizes social and political issues. Originated in the 1950s, and has evolved into many different styles, such as alternative, metal, punk, indie rock, pop punk, grunge, Britpop, and notably today, Ebo. A lot of instruments they use are electric guitars and drums, as you see Mr. Jack Black right there rocking it out. And today's, well, not today's, but famous artist that mostly everybody knows will be Jimi Hendrix, The Beatles, Queen playing in the background, Led Zeppelin, Aerosmith, and Elvis Presley. And you got R&B, which is more like, well, R&B stands for rhythm and blues, so it's more like a soothing music type music. Today's charts are a bit shameful, especially Tuesday, if anybody heard that song. I wouldn't consider that as an R&B song, but today's society is just weird. But it originated in the 1940s. Notable instruments would be drums, saxophones, and horns. Famous artists, well, for today will be Beyonce, Mariah Carey, Mary J. Blige, Usher, Chris Brown. And I really don't think they should be up this. That's a shame for me.
Can you let the first verse play? Thank you, Tito.
So then you got then you got rap, which is a different story.
Yeah,
originated in the 1970s due to block parties where DJs would take a song and then break it up in a percussive way. And the originators were mainly Jamaican, one being DJ Cool Herc, who was known as the founding father of hip-hop. Oh, yes. Turn that down. Not really friends. Hip-hop introduced sampling into music, and what sampling is, they will take one song, let's say from another genre like rock or country, or mainly they have blues, jazz, and disco, and they will alter the sound and include other stuff into it so they can make, you know, what they're doing right now. Notable instruments will be beatboxes, turntables, and drums. And famous artists back in the day, well, these are the top five in my opinion. Tupac, B.I.G., Nas, Jay-Z, and Eminem. And with the charts, that's, to me, that's shameful too. Like really hot boy, like, I don't know. And you got EDM, otherwise known as electric dance music, which is to be the most recent new genre. The term was coined in recently in 2010. Earliest example of EDM will be 1977. And those are the, I'm sure everybody at least heard one song, at least one of the rock. But it's mainly rave music, things you hear in the club, you know, when you turn up, obviously, you know, little Mary Kate, you know, bumping to Lil Jon. Famous artists today will be Skrillex, Calvin Harris, David Guetta, Avicii, and Steve Aoki. And you got Latin music. To be honest with me, every time I hear some type of Latin music, especially Aventura, I want to dance, but I'm bad at dancing. But it originated in the 16th century, was one of the genres that isn't originally from the United States. It was more in the Latin, obviously the Latin states. Notably used the guitar, you see a lot of artists using their guitar. For Aventura, the most notable, well, he's considered one of the best guitarists. And right there you got the pop charts. Enrique Iglesias being up top. And you got my boy Romeo taking two spots right there. And famous artists will be Aventura, Marc Anthony, Shakira, Enrique Iglesias, Celia Cruz. And aside from just Latin music in general, each Hispanic country has their own music they listen to. Like, for example, I'm Peruvian, and in my country, we listen to Afro-Peruvian music. There was an artist who was like the forehead of Afro-Peruvian music. I forgot her name, but she was really big in Peru. Obviously, we listen to these bachata. We have those genres, bachata, salsa, merengue. We also have cumbia, reggaeton, the tango, and ranchero, which they're sort of doing up there. And you have the other genres right here. We have blues, jazz, classical, more of the old days. And you have comedy, which is more recent, which is more like the Lonely Island, if anybody ever heard of him. And then you got kids like, you know, Kids Bop. I don't know how that's a genre, but. And you got K-pop with Psy and all them. And disco back in the old days where we see John Travolta, you know, rocking it over there. And to wrap it off, I wanted to talk about production a bit. Most, if not all songs are produced by artists where the sounds don't naturally just come together like they do. And so here I have my man J. Cole showing everybody how Power Trip, he made Power Trip.
Yo, as soon as I heard that, I said, oh shit, hold up.
You know what it sounds like right there?
Oh, where?
Right there.
Yeah, like, it's like, man, it's just, yeah. But yo, as soon as I heard that part, I knew what I was going to do. I knew I just needed that. Dun, 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 dun. I knew right away that I was going to loop that on top. So then you get this. Then you get.
Presets that you have that you can make a song with, but they're usually not what you wanted. So to do it yourself, you have to have all this equipment, which is not cheap, and you have to add like your own flavor to it. Then you have sampling, which is difficult only for the fact that a lot of artists don't like it when other artists sample their music, which is strange. But that's how production is, and that's the end of my presentation.